I farmed Gluttony so many times just to get a level 4 Peacemaker and it was painful. I was really having trouble getting the Peacemaker synthetic fiber blueprint, that's why it took so long, and because this is a public matchmaking, it made the boss fight incredibly challenging. Now let's talk about the issues that I encountered during the boss fight. First issue and the most common issue I encountered is that most DPS doesn't know when to stop DPSing. The boss has a purple tank on its right arm. If the tank gets full, it is a wipe. Every time a player shoots the boss, the purple bar increases. To prevent the purple tank from getting full, all we have to do is deliver the ice balls to the boss. You can simply do this by having a Valby with a transcendent module called Spiral Tidal Wave, or simply shoot the ice balls to the boss. Now, most players doesn't know that you can actually delay the purple bar from getting full by not shooting the boss. This way, the Valby or the entire party can shoot the ice balls to the boss, thus lowering the purple bar. Talking about Valby, I don't really like how the boss fight is centered about Valby and the module Spiral Tidal Wave. For me, it feels like the only way to make the boss fight mechanic easier is to have a Valby with the special transcendent module Spiral Tidal Wave. I tried fighting this boss without a Valby in the party and it was way too difficult. The boss fight is way harder. Shooting the ice balls to the boss is very challenging, especially after the second immune phase. Season 1 is coming and a new Descendant and the new Ultimate Freyna is going to be released. This also means that a new boss is going to be released. I just hope that the new Ultimate Freyna will not be required to make the new boss fight mechanic easier. Another issue I encountered is that on the immune phase of the boss, every time your party shoots the purple ball near the boss, it increases the purple bar on its arm. The issue is that the Valby is doing all the mechanics in the immune phase or enrage phase. After the enrage phase, the purple bar should reset to zero because in my opinion, the boss just enrage, meaning the boss just use a lot of energy. This also provides time for the Valby to DPS the boss and not just do mechanics all the time. There are moments that all I do in the boss fight is handle the ice balls and the purple balls and nothing else. I don't get a chance to deal damage. It is as if the only reason I exist in the party is to do the mechanics. Now, I do feel that it is kind of unfair because I actually farmed the module and paid gold to upgrade it. I don't want to exist just to do one mechanic. It is not fun doing the ice balls and the purple balls all the time. I actually stopped playing Valby and started playing Sharon against this boss and I had way more fun. There are times where I will assist the Valby player by shooting the ice balls to avoid it from falling to the ground, and assisting the Valby was way more fun. This boss will definitely get a nerf. I just hope that the devs don't overdo it just like what they did to the Frostwalker. After the Frostwalker nerf, it is now a joke. All they had to do was just show the players the real weakness of the Frostwalker and increase the duration of the embers on the floor and that's it. But instead, they made all the parts drop way too much embers, making the mechanic obsolete. Going back to Gluttony, this boss should be transferred to the very hard Void Intercept category. Fighting this boss in public matchmaking is very challenging, but not impossible. There are times where players just immediately leaves because the party only have one Valby, which for me is enough for the entire fight, but to them, it is not enough. There are also players that just get knocked down over and over again. Now, I do know that this boss deals so much damage. Even though I have 85k defense and 16k HP, I still get one-shotted, especially when I'm not focused on the boss or I can't react fast enough. The boss actually gives the players a lot of leeway when it comes to its attack. Its attack is pretty slow and telegraphed. There are times when I'm busy shooting the small adds and not looking at the boss and out of nowhere I get shot by the boss and get knocked down. I don't have issue with this because it is my fault for not watching my position and that's just how it is and you can always run and hide to avoid getting damage. You just have to be patient and not challenge the boss when it focuses you. Now that I am done with my Peacemaker, there is no reason to go back and do this boss. But for sure, in Season 1 when they release Healy and the Ultimate Freyna, the devs will include Gluttony as one of the boss that you will need to grind for the materials for the new Descendant, just like what they did to the Molten Fortress. I just hope that everyone, by the time Season 1 releases, everyone should be able to do Gluttony pretty easily. In my experience, for every 10 runs, I can only successfully defeat this boss 2 or 3 out of 10. And these are the issues that I have experienced on this boss. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.